Hi everyone, in this video I will show you how to implement your aggregate transformation in your Informatica developer. So first of all I will show you my dataset. Now this is my dataset on which I will implement this transformation, and in this I will implement this transformation on these two columns, January salary and February salary. Now I can use such functions of the aggregate transformation, like I can calculate the sum of the particular column or average of the particular column, or find out the min or maximum value of the particular column. Now in this video I will show you how to calculate the sum of the January salary and average of the February salary. Now let's start with this. I will close my data set. I have already created EMP underscore data here. As you can see, I have already created a PDO of this data set having 8 columns, and if you want to see the data you can click on this data viewer tab and click run. Now you can see this is my data on which I will perform this transformation. Now next I will create a mapping by clicking on my project, new and mapping. My mapping name will be 8 underscore cell, and location will be under this repository. My folder will be Pardi. Here I will create this mapping. Finish. Now you can see my mapping is created, aggregate underscore cell. Now first of all, for this I will use my source. My source will be EMP underscore data. I will drag this to the mapping interface and I will choose read option, as I want to read from this source. Now you can see this is my source. These are 8 columns here. Now next is I want to use aggregated transformation. As you can see, you can select it from here and drag it to the, now you can see there are no ports in this transformation, so I will use all the ports of the source. I will press shift down and drag it to the here. Now you can select your transformation, go to the properties, then ports. Now if you want to add some port here, I want to add a port. Name will be sum of Jan salary and data type will be decimal and average of Feb underscore sal. Data type will be decimal and this will be only output port, so I will unselect this input port. As you can see, these two ports are not present in your source, so this will be only output port. Now you can see here, I will click here on this arrow. You can write your formula here. Now you can open this aggregate functions. You can use any aggregate functions here. Now I want to calculate the sum here, so I will double click on sum, then I will go to ports and I want to calculate the sum of January salary, so I will double click on January salary and validate. You can see my expression is valid. Okay. Now you can see expression is changed here. Then I will change it for February. Now I want to calculate the average of February salary. Then again I will go to my aggregate functions. As you can see, these are the aggregate functions. You can use according to your demand. So I will use, double click on average, then go to ports and double click on February salary. Validate. Expression is valid. Okay. Now you can see your expression has changed here. Now I want to create a target. For this I will go to my physical data object new. Select physical data object, flat file data object, create as empty. I want to create an empty flat file. Next, I can change the name here. This will be name of my physical data object here, and this will be location. My delimiter will be comma, and text qualifier will be no quotes. Now you can open this and add as much ports as you want. Now I want to add ID, number, then I will add another port that will be first name, last name, gen salary, data type will be number, feb salary. You can have as many ports as you want in this target. You need not to have all the ports here. Then average of gen salary, data type will be number, and this will be sum here, because I want to calculate the sum of gen salary and average of the February salary. Then you can go to advanced tab and you can set the path where you want to create this. You can set a path here. I'll show you where you have to create. You can go to C drive, Informatica 10.1.1, server, infra shared, target files. Here you want to create your file, so I would select this path and paste it here. And I want to change my name here. My output file name will be aggregate AWG underscore SAL underscore Pradeep. So I can identify my file, and format will be TXT. Then I will press Ctrl S to save this file and go back to my mapping. Now you can use this file here. Target, and you have to use write because I want to write in my target. Now you can connect your aggregate transformation with your target. I'm connecting ID with the ID. You can connect your ports now. Now January salary will be connected with your January salary, and February salary will be connected with your February salary, and this sum will be connected here, and average will be connected here. Now you can save your mapping and save your target file also. Select your aggregate transmission and click on run data. Now you can see the sum of the January salary and average of the February salary. Now you can see this is the this ID, first name, last name. Now you're getting this file, getting this row, and this row is your last row of your data. You can see here, this is the last row of your data set. So here you are getting this last row, and we are interested in these two columns, that is sum of the January salary and sum of the February salary. Now you can select your transformation and go to the properties group by, and you can choose. I will choose no, I have to add one more port here. I will add one more port. That is my department string. You can save this file. Control S. Now you can see department. You can connect your department here. Now Control S, save your mapping. Select your transformation, group by, choose. I want to group by my data according to the department. Click on OK. Now you can see you are grouping your data according to the department. Control S, save, and click here. Run data view. Now you can see you're getting a separate sum of the salary, separate sum of the January salary for CSE department, and same for EC department and IT department, and same in case of average of the February salary. You're getting according to the departments because I have grouped my data according to the department. Now I will show you my file that I created. For this, I have to run my mapping. Click here. Run mapping. Go here, target files, where you have created this file. This is the file that I have created. Now you can see this is your data, result of your transformation that you have created. Now you can create a text file, and you can create any file as according to your wish. I hope you like this video. Thank you and have a nice day.